G'day and welcome to the MacPack Podcast.
We're back.
My name's Jamie Cutter and to my left this week in order of the least number of beers delivered to him at the Gang of Youths concert is my little brother, Dre. How are you, boy?
Jake, I am not doing well and I've got a bone to pick that I'll be picking later with another co-host of this podcast.
And to my right, coming in at 6:01 as he does each and every week, is the baby brother of the pack, who we call Junior Boy. Junior Boy, how are you?
I was sufficient in the amount of beers I had at the Gang of Youths concert.
We love that. We'll be chatting about the Gang of Youths concert off the top.
Fuck yeah.
Along with the fact that Joe may have run into an old cast member. Previous extra from the MacPack Podcast, we only spoke about a couple of weeks ago. Whoa. Riley, you've got another Riley's Roundup. You're going to take us into the deep world of the university life.
Yes, sir.
And give us some tips and tricks. We also have a brand new game. We chat about Harry Styles' audition. And Joe, with back-to-back Everyday Heroes, is going again. It's a massive ep, so let's get into it. Boys!
Brother Mingo!
How are we all? Are we all well?
Feeling good, feeling gravy.
What's going on? I actually seen heaps of you this weekend.
Yeah, you know, yeah. That's nothing to talk about because we were all there together.
Gang of Youths, Friday night?
Yes. Who are the Gang of Youths, Jake?
Was it Friday night?
Saturday night.
Saturday night. Footy, Friday night? We all went to footy. Well.
Yeah, so many hangouts.
That was wet AF.
Hell yeah. Only in one way.
Not a good victorious game for the Purple People Eaters.
No, not good at all.
But
are you starting to stress about Flag Mantle, about your Melbourne tickets that you've booked in many a month ago? Are you starting to stress that they're not going over there?
Pies on the rise. That's all I can say. 10 in a row for the Black and Whites.
Hell yeah.
Not too bad. That's almost double the fixture, like half the fixture that they've won in a row.
Yeah, we head into round 21. So yeah, we're playing finals. Collingwood are definitely playing finals. I think Fremantle would... I think they're 100% chance as well. Now.
I think they're still playing finals. Yeah.
I don't know. But I mean, I don't think they can bow out to finals contention. I might be wrong.
But that's the thing with footy. Going to footy is a gamble. You're either going to have a great night or you're going to have a terrible night, depending on how your team goes. But that was not the case on Saturday. We were locked in for
Gang of Youths.
Guaranteed entertainment.
We were. Yes. It was a great night.
At the Rack.
Yeah, Rack Arena.
R.A.C.
The three of us went down. We went and saw
the old stomping grounds.
We went and saw a Gang of Youths in 2018, Joe and I.
Yes.
Down the Fremantle Arts Centre.
Yep.
And they returned this year to R.A.C. Arena in Perth. Great night. One of the better gigs I've ever been to.
Yeah, it was good, yeah.
Absolutely unreal.
They're a rock band.
They're good, yeah. They're like stadium rock people. You know what I mean? Like, there's not like a lot of bands at a show are like more like, you know, your low-key, indie, chill vibes. But these are like, you know, they got like the orchestra shit. They got they're hyping you up.
It's hard to define them because even in the Uber on the way to the 21st after Gang of Youths concert, the Uber was like, oh, what kind of band are they? And I said rock. But when I think of a rock band, I think of AC/DC.
Yeah, so they're like...
alternative rock, aren't they?
Yeah, alt rock or like Baroque pop, which is like pop that has
Baroque
pop, which is...
Oh, Baroque. Obama pop.
Yeah, it's like rock music that has a lot of instruments you might not usually see in
the violin
rock music.
The violin guy.
More classical instruments being used in like a rock way.
I was chatting with a bloke from work. I won't mention his name. I don't know if he wants to be associated with. I was chatting with him this morning and he said apparently the violinist from Gang of Youths is like an absolute jet and he's just a really switched on musician. Like the fact that he can play the violin is cool, but he's like Einstein level, Sinatra level, like intelligence when it comes to music as well. Apparently, he wrote majority of this album.
Oh, really? Oh, I think
that could be our first.
Hey yo, what the?
What was that, Jacob? Play it again.
Hey yo, what the fuck?
Oh, we're debuting a brand new thing. We got a brand new sound from the soundboard. Whenever we drop a mad fact, we're just gonna give it a bit of.
Hey yo, what the fuck?
Because that's exactly what we're thinking.
Yeah,
and
exactly.
Probably what you're thinking.
So play along at home. You can basically just insert that in your mind wherever you think it'll fit.
Yeah.
Probably won't come up anywhere near as frequently as we think it will.
Because we don't have that many groundbreaking opportunities.
But hey, we'll play it by ear.
Yeah, you thought we played the air horn a lot when we first got that. You wait.
Yeah, now we can double up.
Do you know what's really cool about the Gang of Youths concert?
Dave kissed me.
Holy shit.
Dave did a big old...
Who's Dave?
Dave, the lead singer of the gang. He's the leader of the gang.
Literally. Tell us the story, Jake. What happened?
So he comes down. He just jumped off the stage. I didn't realize how close we were to the stage until...
Because it came... There was like the penis, platform bit that came
it
out.
It was like shaft size. Like it was really shaft shaped.
A traverse stage. Yeah.
And they had like a big peen sort of come out.
Yeah.
Did you notice that?
Yeah.
Like
yeah,
it was white. It was white at the back.
Like a catwalk.
It's like like the yellow Tetris piece, you know? It's got the side bit and then it pops out the middle.
That's exactly it.
I think so. Yeah.
Yes, it is the one.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. and so he started walking towards us pretty early on and I was like, fuck, we're actually well closer than I thought we were. Yeah. And then he decided to hop off the stage.
Yeah, this is during Magnolia, which is probably like the climax of the concert.
Yeah, yeah. We were all climaxing.
Some more than others.
It was an incredible moment. He jumped off the stage and I was like, oh, that's sick. Like for the people down the front.
Yeah, he's at the front.
Good on him.
Yeah, that's cool.
At this point, I've got two beers in my hand and...
Yeah, we'll get to that later.
and Dave starts, I just noticed he starts making his way to my right. Like he's there and he's slowly coming up.
He's pushing his way through the crowd.
Yeah, he's pushing through the marsh. There's no marsh existing for him.
And I've decided that it's now or never. And I just start just busting my ass to get there. There's beer going everywhere. I felt sorry for the dude in front of me who literally wore half of a can of beer all down in the back of his shirt.
Oh, of yours.
It was all happening so fast. I ended up knocking this one back entirely.
Climaxing, knocking beer everywhere.
So I've got one in my right hand, one in my left hand, but I'm like, how can I document this moment if my phone's in my pocket?
Yes, God forbid. A moment lived and not filmed.
And, well, you'll see the proof is in the pudding. Great flick.
Great footage.
Great content creator.
Oh, yeah. Fantastic.
Knock back the beer, throw the beer up in the air, quickly grab my phone, and then we're on, like marching with pure determination and grit.
Hell yeah.
Get there. I'm sure we'll show the videos. Next thing you know, like...
He's there.
I've made such good ground that I sort of, by the time I got my phone looked up, he was smack bang in front of me.
David!
And I'm holding my phone and just like looking at him.
He's like, ah!
And he just sort of like ran into me.
Kiss me, David.
sort of ran.
Kiss like, me yeah. on the mouth.
He just came banging.
He dropped his shoulder into his chest. <came,
laughs> I said, fuck off.
came banging straight into me. And then there's a few seconds. Like it wasn't like he hit and then fell off. I sort of got carried with him for a bit in this
wave of Dave. He's quite a buff dude.
Oh, yeah. He's not small.
Nah.
I felt like I could hang off his arm and he was carrying me through the abyss. Vince was there. Yep. Vince followed me. And I think Vince was right behind me, and then as Dave sort of went past, Vince appeared, and I just remember filming him, and he was the look on that man's face. Again, we'll show you the video. It was quite large. I'm chatting with Vincent, but still like holding my phone up, and then I quickly became aware because the stage is still back there. He wasn't just like walking home to Frio or anything.
Yeah,
he was always going to come back to the stage.
He's doing a round trip,
and it was at that point I realized he's coming straight back to the stage. And he quickly turned around. I've just gone. You can hear me in the video go, he's coming back. He's coming back. Like it was such a shock that he was ever going to return.
Oh, my God.
And then as he's returned, I'm still filming. One of the boys, the same boy that I just mentioned from work, has a great video of me from about 5 meters back.
Hell yeah.
And you can just clearly see me arm fully stretched with my phone trying to get like the best dolly shot just with my phone, and it was fantastic. It was an absolute moment. Spun around, Cody's wearing the MacPack hat. She just timely put that on.
Cody Ritchie,
her first debut in the MacPack VIP. She slapped that on, and that was just like pure timing. And then the rest of the night just kicked on.
Fuck yeah,
fantastic! A successful night.
It was unreal.
Do you know what sucked though? I was standing next to Jake for the whole first half of the concert,
and then he dipped.
But I had to dip for a reasonable reason. One of my mates hit the freaking deck, boy.
Yeah, he went down.
Fainting.
He went down freaking hard.
He went down like a sack of spuds.
My boy passed out. Joshua DeCruz.
Like, it was a pretty overwhelming. It was an overwhelming night, but at no point did I think I was going to pass out.
Nah, and it was a pretty chill watch.
Jake's friend, Vincent,
oh yeah.
He thought that Josh was just trying to, like, get back to... Like, he was trying to leave.
Yeah.
So, he stepped out of the way. Fall before he realized.
Just, like, pulled the chair out of the
way. He thought he was, like, pushing to sort of, like, oh, I'm going to head back. He just hit the deck.
Yeah, it was a really chill, like, it's like Frio vibes mosh. So, everyone's just, like, Triple J vibing out, you know? It's not like we were at the Tyler Creator concert 5 days earlier. And that was, like, fucking bumping, you know? Like, there was no need to be fainting in this mosh. But Joshua went down. I went outside with him. I got a message from Jake saying, oh, while you're out there, just grab us a few beers.
Yeah, Jake was very concerned with Josh's safety.
To begin with.
Yeah, of course. Yeah, to begin
until
with.
Until beers were on the table.
Beers were on the table.
Forever the opportunist. Well, only 5 minutes before I said to you, I was like, chances of us quickly ducking, going to get some beers and coming back.
Yeah.
And then I turned around and realized like how many people were behind us.
Yeah.
And it quickly looked like quite a task to do that. So we just both decided, no, we weren't going to do that.
Yeah. And I said, who are the beers for? And the text chain went like this.
Oh, yeah. This is when you actually went out. So you've gone out to get beers.
Yep.
And I've just gone, while you're out there, you might as well quickly just line up and get us some supplies on your way back.
Yeah.
Riley's come back with a who wants one.
And you've messaged in our little MacPack chat and you've gone, I'll have a beer. And then I replied with, I think I said like, yeah, and Vince,
Cody
and Rafferty. Liam Rafferty and myself.
That's four.
Yeah.
So I grabbed four.
Yeah.
And I head back to the marsh.
And Raf got his own.
And I fully forgot about getting Joey his.
Yeah.
So we start dishing out all the cans.
Oh, Joey. I'm there vibing away at the concert, having a great time.
Did you put your hand out?
Knowing that soon my dear young brother will return with a tasty beverage for me to consume.
Yeah.
And I was having a quiet night. I had only had one drink at Pre's. I had driven us all to the train station and was going to be driving people back home. But I thought, you know what? It's a long concert. I can have a second drink.
Nah, maybe it was a responsible call from you to not get him a drink.
So yeah. Riley's come back. He's come back.
Oh, you got your RSA. Maybe you were doing the right thing.
Yes.
There you go.
Comes back with his arms full of beers. And I'm like, oh, that looks like a tasty Hahn, which I never really had a Hahn before.
They're bad. Anyway. I did you again.
I've never had a Hahn, but I was excited to give it a try. Riley comes fast, and I think Jake had already gotten beers at this point.
I had a beer delivered.
Are we going to say...
Maybe we won't. All I think we've already been noted by RSC for some logistical tacticians that have been used in the past.
There was some more sneaky business going on.
There was a little bit of sneaky business.
So Jake had already
got value for money sort of operation.
Beer from his friend. And Riley comes walking in with the beers. He's got them. And I'm like, oh, cool. Like, he's got like a lot, you know, in his hands. Like, time for me to take one of these bad boys for myself.
I start dishing them out.
And I had the hand. And then they all just go straight to Jake. Yeah. And I was sort of standing there, and then they're all like, gone.
I grabbed one, gave it to Vince. I was like, there you go, brother. And I thought you might have missed out, Riley.
No, nah, you made never missed
I did check with Rafferty. I was like, did Riley get a beer? Cause
I didn't see the message, Joey, but I owe you a beer one day.
There you go.
One day, yeah.
You can have one now. We'll go to the fridge. I'll walk out of the fridge and get you a little, frosty.
Maybe that'd be a nice little bicycle.
But yeah, I missed out on going to kiss Dave as well because I was right next to you, Jake. But then for the rest of the night, I was just standing behind Josh, spotting him in case he went down again. I was there as his little wiki keeper.
Yeah, that's nice. Nice looking after a friend. Yes. And speaking of friends, I'd love to call back to a story I told, 2-3 weeks ago about my run-in with my dear friend, my dear friend Michael at GYGY. I went up to Michael and I said, hey, Michael, you know, you're my dear friend. And he said, no, I'm not Michael.
Hey, yo, what the fuck?
That's literally what Michael said.
That was my reaction. Anyway, so
you touched him. He just turned to you and went, hey, yo, what the fuck?
So I had this awkward interaction with this one guy, but led to a funny story to tell my friends here. And then I got a message.
Your friends.
I mean, you guys, my brothers. And then I got a message.
My associates.
I got a message from Michael because he'd watched the YouTube video where I'd
Mikey.
Where
how did he find out as well?
So I did tell him about the night. I was like, I saw someone who I like looked like you. Like, and then I guess someone who listens must have
connections
mentioned it to him. Because as far as I know, he's not a Friday fiend or anything. He doesn't listen every week.
He got on quick.
Yeah, he was quick. I've got a feeling my suspicion might be Clarky, could be.
Clarky. Okay.
But it could have been anyone, you know. You never know who's listening. So you better watch out. I had an awkward interaction with this guy, but it rekindled my friendship with Michael. Actually, I'm going bowling with Michael tomorrow.
Oh,
tomorrow.
Wait, real Michael or fake Michael?
Real Michael. Yes. I'm going bowling with tomorrow. So me and Michael and also Emily, we're all dear friends in kindy.
Yeah, they were the ones that were in that photo.
Yeah, the victory, yeah.
And then last night, I went to that cinema again, the Lunar Leaderville Cinema.
Shout out.
You should get a photo of you three tomorrow and then we'll put the side by side.
Yeah, okay, yeah.
Who's going to take it?
Yeah, we'll have to ask.
Self-timer.
Yes,
one of the staff members.
Oh, that'll be fun.
Yeah, can you take a photo of us three? You gotta make sure you're standing in the same spot.
So I go to see Luna Leaderville. Return to the scene of the awkward interaction.
Don't assume they haven't listened. They'll understand the context. Yeah.
Even though this episode's not out yet. Oh, the bowling gang. Anyway, so go to Luna Leaderville, right? There to see another classic movie. So we're sitting there, waiting in line, and then who do I see? But it's fucking fake Michael again.
Fakey!
We run into him again.
Son of a bitch.
I've seen him, and I've gone, I'm going to bowl with that guy. No, wrong guy. But the thing is, I don't know if he would remember me. Because
oh,
like,
I reckon he would.
Oh, nah, you would.
Yeah, but just like a fun, like...
Did you say anything?
Not
no,
Michael.
No, I didn't say
process that. Of elimination.
Did you lock eyes?
No, I was just like head down, you know, yeah. Look away. Yeah.
Was the cookie guy there?
No.
Sure. Oh, that's a heartbreaking moment. All right, boys, very excited to be back with only the second iteration of one of our favourite new little segments.
Back,
right,
baby.
Right on the eve of uni's new semester, it's time for Riley's Roundup.
Of course it's time for Riley's Roundup. University's best, he's the rootinest, tootinest, uni shooting in the wild, wild west. That's right, baby. Going back to uni has got me thinking about uni again.
Hence, how long do you get off? You get like 3 months off.
You get 2 months off this time around and then 4 months off at the end of the year.
Oh. Must be
lovely.
Very, very nice.
But it doesn't feel that long. It doesn't feel that long though. Like, it happens real quick.
No, but when you think about uni, you literally go to uni for like 12 weeks and then you have exams.
Yeah.
And off those 12 weeks, you go for about four hours a week.
Yeah, it's so chill. Yeah, enjoy while you can, kids.
Oh, trust me.
The best years of your life. Eh?
I am enjoying it. I'm enjoying it a little bit too much though.
If you're enjoying this week's episode of the podcast, the best thing that you can do to show us a little bit of support is to share it with your mates. Whether it's a story on Instagram, a private message to a pal.
A DM.
Slide into those DMs. Do whatever you need be. Or even just like message your mum and be like, these guys, they swear a lot. But like,
I prefer Gmail as well.
Yeah, Gmail's good.
Gmail's good.
It's slow. Like, it's a very slow and formal way.
I click on any link I get.
Yeah, nice. Fair enough. So yeah, chuck it on your Instagram story or send it to a mate. But whatever you do, we just want to grow this little baby pack.
Fantastic. And then every week you can chatter about the pack with your pack.
There you go. Exactly. All right. Ooh. Let's hear it. So the first roundup you did was about just not doing any work and submitting blank pieces of paper.
And getting a pass grade.
And getting a tick. Now, what have we got this time around?
All right. So this time around, it was a different subject. This subject was called content creation. And lovely. I signed up for it thinking, cool.
Fuck, that is such a grim place of where we are at the moment.
How content so? Creation.
Yeah. Imagine.
I did a linear regression and the implication of parabolic motion.
Imagine being like a 40-year-old dude who went to uni. Firstly, uni was hard to get into when you, like, prehistoric times.
Yeah.
Now they just let you in for anything. I imagine.
You guys.
Apparently there's a Harry Styles course coming up.
You guys want to learn about memes?
Literally, I imagine content creation is instead of just like memes. Turning your phone on. Yeah.
And also, Riley's doing an art degree, which is way more expensive than like a useful one.
Yeah, well, that's where all that content creating will come in handy then.
Yeah, but it's a shocker though, because I thought like content creation would be fun, but apparently not. Apparently, it's more about like articles and news stories.
Oh, okay.
But I was knee deep, so I was doing the freaking course.
Doing the content.
First assessment came up, and we had to write this like paper kind of this whole like I forgot what it's named.
An essay.
Yeah, but it's more like a media release kind of stuff.
Oh, okay.
So,
what is a hashtag?
Yeah, it's basically like how people, like something someone will send to the producers of a show to then
press release.
Do the show, yeah. Yeah. And then, yeah, to do the press.
Cool. Effective class.
Doesn't sound like you really understood the assignment.
Well, that's where the issue lies. We were tasked to do it about the uni, kind of advertising how good the uni is, okay. And make a press release about the good uni to send to, I don't fucking know, someone.
Doesn't sound like you
journos or some fucking bullshit.
You pass this thing?
And then, so I did the whole assignment and then submitted it and I was like, damn. I went beast mode with this. This was the day. I did this the day that we had Cade Gizzeroni on the pod. I was at uni all day doing this assignment. Uploaded it. She's Apple.
Just the one day.
Crazy. I had to interview one of my chutes about it. And unfortunately, he's a bit of a pessimist. And he's not a big fan of the uni. So I got a bit of a negative stance on it. So I wrote my whole paper from kind of the opposite side. Yeah, of like the negatives.
The guy hates his job.
And then I got an email after a week or two of the market, and they were like, "Oh, Riley, you misunderstood the assignment."
That's so shocked to me, because the way you've described it is
beast mode.
Watertight.
So they email me and they're like, "You did all right. You did very all right, but like you misunderstood, and you kind of this was meant to be an advertisement for the uni to say how good this is compared to other ones, but you've kind of gone on how shit this fucking place is and how corrupt it is, especially at the top.
If the boot fits."
Yeah.
And I was like, aye, captain, that's me. And
you're a bit of a maverick.
And then I was like, so what's the goaty go? What's the goaty go to go go? And I emailed that back and said like,
what's the goaty go?
Okay,
go 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 go.
Question mark. And then I just clicked it, sent it from my iPhone. I read and sent an email back. She's sitting on the shitter at like fucking midday Thursday. Anyway, and then and then they emailed back and they're like, yeah, you need to like have a meeting with the coordinator of the course.
That's the goity go go.
Can you come in like either the start of next week or like tomorrow? And I was like, see if I can make it fit in my schedule. So then I popped in.
Did it fit? Obviously.
The chick was like,
had a spare hour or so.
Yeah, so she emailed. I was emailing her now, and she was like, can you meet me at like 10:45 Friday? And I was like,
felt a bit late.
I was like, yeah, I can meet you at 10:45 Friday. And then but then I finished one of my classes. I had my class finished at 10:30, and then I was like walking upstairs trying to find her office. Found her office, and the course that I was actually the class, I only had one class for this unit. It was online, 8:30 a.m. on a Wednesday. I talked to my other mates in the class.
Your life is so easy.
One of my mates also, yeah. Well, I talked to a few other of my mates in the class. One of them is Evan Gosney from the PNC Lads.
And
we shared this in common. We had quite a common thread here that we'd kind of join the call and then roll back over into bed and fall asleep. So that was kind of the common denominator of why I didn't understand the assessment.
Because you slept through it.
I slept through the brave. Anyway, so then I'm walking toward this chick's office, and I hear the unit coordinator on the phone Zoom call with my teacher.
That's the guy from my dreams.
On the phone call with my teacher. And I'm waiting like just around her door, like walking through. And then I'm like, wait a minute. Like, she's on the phone. I'll just wait out here until she hangs up. And I realize, oh, that's my teacher's voice. and then she was like, yeah, it's 10:44. I hope Riley's still coming. Like, it's getting close. I've just come into uni just for this. And I was like, oh, what a darling. Anyway. And then she was like,
so is he on call for the meeting? Is that what's happening?
No, just like to brief on like what
the fuck,
who I
wrong?
Am, what's going on. Yeah, like okay, just touch up on a little details. And then I heard him say, I think he's kind of joining the call, and then he's not doing much for the rest of the call. I don't know if he's really paying attention or if he's even
there.
Yeah. And at that point I was like, they're bringing on to me. And I had my keys in my pocket, so I just grabbed my pocket keys and then took a few steps back. So I didn't swing the door over and be like, g'day, miss. I heard everything. So I waited. I waited a few seconds. So at this point, I was like, shit me dead. Now they're on to me.
Yeah.
I failed an assignment. And now I'm going to have a meeting with this teacher. So I walk in, I'm wearing like all black. This is like,
you're wearing PJs and on a nightcap.
My mullet was in fruition. It was all spiked up. I was looking like a real fucking uni, not a uni student.
Yeah.
So I swing the door open. I'm like, g'day, miss. I'm Riley. How you going?
She's never met you.
No, shook her hand. She was a lovely lady. And sat down. And then she was like, oh, yeah. So we're just talking about the assignment. Like, I've just had a read through it. Like, you did quite well. You just, kind of misunderstood it. And she was like, so what are you trying to get out of this course? And I was like, you son of a bitch, you're on to me.
Just a pass, I guess.
Yeah, I was like, oh, this is one of my electives. I'm doing film. And she was like, ah, fair enough. I can see this. And then
lack of effort.
Yeah. And then
leaking off your spiky hair. Yeah.
And then after we talked a little bit, wait, no, I'll tell you that after. Yeah, so then we're talking a bit, and she was like, oh, were you in the class yesterday morning? And I was like, yeah, fucking of course I was.
Pop quiz.
Like, and she was like, yeah, did you hear what our guest speaker had to say about stuff?
No.
And I was like,
this is a test.
Oh, fucking oath it was. But then I was like,
there was no guest speaker.
Because I was there at the start and I remembered her first name was like Jess or something. She was like, did you hear what Jess had to say? And I was like, yeah. And she was like, what were your thoughts? And I can't remember how I did it, but I fucking batted it off with a passion. I smacked that shit out of the park the first time she asked me.
So what do you think your response was to this?
Oh, it was something like she was like, oh, did you say in the see what she was going with this kind of assignment, what you got to do with it? And I was like, yeah, like, I understood. I just kind of struggled with this aspect and kind of like just took it down another path. I was like, yeah I get
the
that.
Politician the bait answer. And switch.
But let's talk about something that I'm struggling with, not the stuff I understand.
The look over there answer.
Yeah, exactly, right? And then so we started talking a bit more. She was like, yeah, so you did like everything right. So I can give you a 50% mark.
Yeah, okay. just walk out. The paper's like spinning.
So I give you a 50% pass mark. Or you can do it again and you'll probably get like a 70, 80. Like, that's how, all right, you're doing all right. Like, your work is pretty good.
And you're like, I don't want to take that gamble.
And I was basically like, oh, I have to think about it. I got a few other assignments coming up. And she was like, you know what? I have a son around your age as well. You're very similar to him. And she was like.
So she's fucked up as well.
And she was like, yeah, so like, what did you think of when Jess mentioned this kind of stuff in yesterday's thing? And again, fucking battering it off. I don't know how I did it. I can't remember because this was months ago now. But then she asked me three separate times. And I remember my heart sinking three times. But I remember scooting out of it. And then we kind of kept talking a bit. I was probably there for like 10 minutes. Then I kept asking her questions.
Yeah, good.
I was like, oh, so did you used to do this kind of stuff before you worked here? Because she was a bit of an older statesman. And I noticed that she had like all her freaking PhDs up on the wall and stuff. And I was like, oh, so you also studied at the University of Melbourne or whatever. And then she was like, yeah, I did my bachelor's there. I don't know if I can, all that fun little words that they talk about at uni. And then,
used to sleep through many lectures, miss.
And then she was like, yeah, so, do you want the 50% or do you want to do it again? And I was like, let's be honest, miss, I'll take that 50%. I'll be on my way. And then so I took the 50% and I went on my way. And then,
oh my God.
I did quite well in the course after that. Kept sleeping through them. did a presentation. I had this presentation that I had to do with me and another one of my classmates. Never talked to him before. But he went friggin' AFK for the whole semester. Literally didn't reply to any of my friggin' emails or the teachers or didn't join any of the calls after we had to do our friggin' presentation together. I was messaging him on Facebook as well. I was like, I found him on Facebook. I was like, bro, are we doing this or not? And then I had to do that solo dolo. So I think my teacher actually really appreciated that I did it solo. And then I also did an interview at the end where I had to pretend to be like a journalist. And I fucking passed that with flying colours as well. And then on my last day at uni, so this is all an online class. So I never met anyone in the class other than the people I already knew or the teacher. And then my last day of uni in the semester, I was heading to the library to study. With Kate, actually, heading to the library to study. I was walking down the halls of Murdoch and I walked past my teacher and I looked at him and went,
him.
That's him.
Him or her?
I think of his webcam.
No, my teacher. He's always on his webcam.
I thought it was a girl.
No, that was the unit coordinator.
Okay, sorry.
But my actual teacher was a male.
Oh, no.
And then we made eye contact and we both were like, and he was like, I was like, oh my God, that's my teacher that thinks I'm a dropkick. And he was like, and he was like, hey, there's that shin that's a dropkick. And I didn't say anything to him. But yeah, that was it. That was all from that. And I got the pass grade. So you don't need to be in the class to pass. Because I remember saying last year, I was like, you don't need to watch lectures to pass. Don't even go to the tutes, mate.
So it's the tutes you're not even going to. I thought it was
no,
the
I was
lectures.
There. I was joining them because I think he caught on because it's on like this on this like Murdoch call system. So you join the call, but you actually have to disconnect from the call.
you're not
when the class ends and all the
just you and the teacher. Still
all
in
the
there.
Teachers disconnect.
Three days after the class.
All the students disconnect, and I assume after the first week when he went, Riley. Are you okay? Like, why are you still in the call? Like, the class is over, man. And then I assume after a few weeks of him saying that I was still chilling in class an hour after, He was probably like, this kid isn't fucking here.
This kid is putting in the hard yards.
Yeah, literally. He's on the grind.
Oh, my. Well, that's some good learnings. I reckon there should be a uni course, a whole unit based around just following him and learning life hacks. Yeah. Just how to really bottom feed and still get by.
Yeah. What's like the highest prestige? Like, do people get awards at the end of their...
You won't. Don't worry about that. All right, boys, time today, brand new game. We've got so many games in the back catalogue.
I know, we've been having requests. Oh, do the games. We love the games. You know, do one of your classic games. You know what? Fuck you. We're doing a brand new game.
I don't think we've ever played a game more than like 3 times.
It's because they're not good enough.
And we also love to do like little brand new songs for them. This game is centred around the fact that Riley's a bit of an actor. And so he's pretty good at impressions, or so he likes to think.
Oh, pretty good.
So the game is basically he's going to address us with a couple of examples of some impressions, and we have to guess them. Let's see how we go.
His impressions are meant to be good, no matter what he's got possessed. We said we'll guess them if we could. It makes me wonder if his impressions will be understood, because we haven't heard them yet. But we're hoping that they're good, because they're impressions that we guess.
That's 3 gentlemen screaming into a microphone.
It sounds much worse than I thought it would have.
I thought it sounded great.
It's very shouty.
Oh, yeah. That's kind of how they went with it as well.
It's sort like of a pub anthem.
It is. That's shouty. Just wait.
Okay. Well, that's exciting. So the game is impressions that we guess.
So Riley will do an impression?
Riley's going to do an impression, and Joe and I are basically just going to guess him. First person, it's best of 3. So basically, first person to get 2 wins.
Yep.
But we'll do the last one as a victory lap if one of us.
There are no tie breaks.
Rightio. So this
there are no winners in this.
The way I'll be doing this, gentlemen, is I'll be singing when we play this game. I'll be singing a popular song.
Singing.
I'll be like kind of spoken word the lyrics of the song in impersonation. Of the voice.
Wow, that is a
really elaborate.
It's a dynamic I wasn't really ready for.
Okay, and the song.
I'm not too sure of the name, but it was big on TikTok. It's the lyrics go, I ain't never been with a baddie.
Oh, okay. I thought you
she's
meant like
added to the tally.
I thought you would be like, I thought you were so gonna be like, okay,
so I could do like Mr. Brightside, but I'm not doing Mr. Brightside.
Okay, this week's
so
song.
It's all gonna be the same.
Can we play the song? Can we just play a little bit of the song, or is that gonna be too hard for you to do live?
Might be a bit too hard for me to do live,
especially when you don't know what the song's called.
No.
I've never been with a baddie.
Because when he first
why don't you just sing it for us a bit, Joe?
When he first did it, I thought he meant that it was gonna be like he's going to do a different song per person.
Oh no! Don't be silly. Like,
so yeah, this is Bob Dylan doing Katy Perry's "Raw," and then it's kind of like, but well, why? How why was that song chosen for this?
So
this
every
voice?
Week is gonna have a themed song.
Every week, this is a weekly segment. We're getting rid of the everyday.
Every
era.
Version of this game is gonna have a song dedicated to it.
Yeah, and then also, so I'm gonna do the impression with the song. I've got 3 different impressions.
Yeah, okay. And that's mainly so you're not stuck doing like a.
I don't want to say
like,
what they
hey,
say.
It's me. It's the pizza guy. Like, you know,
or glad you're not doing the impressions just between us.
I also don't want to say something that they would say.
Yes,
would give
exactly.
it away.
That's
it's
purely based on the.
How
impression.
Are we looking with the actual song?
Yeah, it's working. But I'm also
on?
Yeah, not yet. Okay. But also, what I'm doing as well, if you guys don't get it, I'm just going to be saying kind of something that they would say.
Oh, okay. So this
that
is
they
like
have said as like a little bit of an extra. So
second hint.
It'll click. This is the song. Big on TikTok.
Yeah,
so this will be the one that I'm using.
So that's the tune that we're running with.
Yes.
I appreciate that. That's good. I don't know how he's going to be able to do it. Who's that by?
What?
Who is the song by?
A lot of questions from him.
Don't worry. Let's go. So, buzzers, are your names?
Yep.
First of 2 wins, essentially.
Okay, ready? I never been with a baddie. just come tighter to the tally. Madison, but I'm Connor Maddie.
Hey, yo, what the fuck? Can we hear that again?
Go, you gotta go.
ain't never been with a baddie. But I'm going to add it to that.
Wait, if I buzz in now, and then you get a guess, yep. And then we hear the hint.
I think so. I think that's the only fair way we can do this.
I'm gonna go Joe, and it's the like slug lady from Monsters Inc.
Not what I was going for, but that was an option that I didn't choose.
All right,
you know, like the Mike Wazowski.
Oh, that's pretty close. I was gonna go Mr. Krabs from SpongeBob.
Nah.
Okay.
Right. Real life character.
Okay. It was so ridiculous.
I'm just finding out.
It must be a drawing of sorts.
How about I'll break it down into... This is just a little one. It's a comedian.
I never been with Addy. And I'm going to add it to Dally. Medicine. But I'm calling her Maddie.
What is happening?
But I'm calling her Maddie.
Oh, Joe, it's Pete Davidson.
It's Pete Davidson!
Oh, it's not a good impression.
Can we get it now that we know? Can we get it one more time?
I ain't never been with a baddie.
It's not bad. It's not bad.
But I'm calling her, man.
Can you do... What would you have done if we got to the second hint?
Oh, I was just going to say, Kim Kardashian.
At first when you're like, I thought you were like it sounds like you're buzzing into like an apartment building.
No, that's not what I was going for.
That was good. Right, that was actually not bad. That was not bad. So that set the context.
We were taken aback.
I win that one.
Yeah. I don't know if anyone won after that, but
the listeners.
Fuck. Right. If anyone got that, fuck, please ping us a message.
Someone's just yelling. It's Pete.
I would love to play this over the phone with someone. I think this is a really good one.
Yeah, we could get some fans.
We definitely could. So if you
reckon you're good enough at this.
If you got that, fuck me, Dad. Congratulations.
Yeah, you could be featuring on the MacPack Podcast, guessing.
Easily, yeah. Okay, next one. How would you do Pete Davidson? Would you have an...
it'd be like...
It's actually pretty accurate. Because
where is he? Staten Island.
It was probably a couple octaves too low and quite aggressive.
I thought it was like an older gentleman or something.
Yeah.
I was scared it was going to get mixed up with Adam Sandler. For a bit of the...
No fear of that, I don't think.
I don't even...
Mike Mazowski's who it got mixed up with.
Yeah, I don't know what I'd do. Something like a...
Here we go. This will be good.
The thing about working on Saturday Night Live.
Yeah, that's pretty good.
But you can't do that. He's doing
he's
the
just
song.
Talking about what he's
doing the song. All right.
That's the hard part, boys. That's
give us a
I'm
second
doing.
One. I like the song choice as well. This could grow legs. Yeah. This could potentially get a second run. This. Potentially.
Yeah, just wait.
That's fine.
I ain't never been with a bat. She's calm, so I add her to the tally. Madison, but I'm calling her Maddie.
Is it Jerry Seinfeld?
No.
Oh,
right, you didn't buzz in. But I'm gonna go Jimmy Fallon.
No.
Just put some music over
there. I'm gonna give you a gender.
Yeah.
Oh my!
It's Janice. It's Janice from Friends.
It's Janice from Friends.
I did think that off the top, but I don't know. It was a bit too male dominated. But no, there
that
we go.
That is because of my low octave voice. Here we go.
Are
this,
we calling
this
that
next
a
one?
Win?
I'm excited for. I accidentally said I the freaking quote.
Yeah. Wow. So it's a nil or draw. This is the decider.
This is the one.
How sad. How would you have done that? That one was actually good.
That one.
I ain't never been.
Yeah, no, it was good. That was good. People would have got that.
Yeah.
Not us, but people.
You guys, Jake, you do it.
Nah.
Do it, Janice.
I'm not doing it, Janice.
Yeah, fair enough.
Chandler Bang.
Good. Almost. Good. I definitely think it's going to be your role to do the impressions.
Which is scary. Here we go.
I love the idea of this music.
It's good,
been added into it as well.
Ready?
Especially the song choice. It's really important to get a good song choice.
To warm up the vocals on this one. Ready? 3, 2.
I ain't never been. Oh no, this is rough. I ain't. Oh shit. I'm striking out.
Three bubbles.
All right.
I. I ain't. Oh shit! I'm stuck in Janice. I gotta get her out of my head. Here we go. I ain't never been with a baddie. She's gone. Tied her to the telly. Madison, but I'm crawling. A maddie.
How are you on, boy? our
minds. This is not an easy game. You got any?
I've never been without it.
Keep going.
She's gone. But I had her to the trolley.
It's someone from like Hotel Transylvania or something.
Almost.
We need a second. We need a second.
Yeah.
We need a little bit of a hint. Yeah.
Tri-state area.
Oh, Jake. The dude from Phineas and Ferb.
We're gonna need a name.
The guy, Dr. Ah, fuck.
Dr. Heinz Doofenshmirtz.
Yeah,
we'll give it to you, Jake.
Yeah, we all knew what I was gonna say. That was good.
Thank
Again,
you.
I thought it, but after we did it, do the
bitch.
Cartoons, I thought we'd make it.
Yeah, going
away.
Back to IRL.
All right, that was good. That was good. That was the first debut.
Yeah, it was a warm up game.
I don't think we got any.
Nah.
I sort of
got Janice, but it was a cheat.
It's a fucking tough game.
Yeah, it is, yeah. I feel like the impressions were decent.
Impressions were good. It'd be great to have the actual people. Maybe for next time we'll have the actual people.
Lined up as well
so we can see how accurate he was.
There you go.
Look, we're just forever learning. We're workshopping it. We're 97 episodes in.
See, maybe that's why this game will come back. Because we're already thinking of ways to make it
Here
better.
We go. I like it. But one thing we'll never make any better is the implorious little intro that we've got for it.
I think we're a bit too beast mode with this one.
We did. The segment could be improved.
I think it was a good one, yeah.
I don't know if this could be improved.
His impressions are meant to be good. No matter what he's got possessed. We'll guess him if we could. It makes me wonder if his impressions will be understood. Because we haven't heard him yet. But boy, we're hoping that they're good, because they're impressions that we get.
All right, boys, did you see this week? I don't know what the reason behind it was, but the X Factor in, I think it's America, is it American X Factor?
UK.
UK X Factor.
Britain's Got Talent. Or is it X Factor?
It's X Factor.
Oh.
Has released the unedited version of the Harry Styles audition.
Holy shit.
Yeah, well, they also, I feel like 2 weeks ago, last week, they put out a video of, it was a video of them, the judges, picking the boys who went into the boy band as well.
Okay.
So they've just been...
Are we on the hunt for a new boy band? Is that what seems to be happening? Is that what you're thinking?
Yeah, I don't know. They're just going through the archives of the 1D story.
I don't mind it. There seems to be a little bit that was left out of his original audition.
Harry's.
Yeah, which seems to hold a little bit of context. We'll play it for you now. This is the full edition.
Yeah, so not what went to air.
Not what went to air. This is the full, unedited, uncensored, brand new...
Uncut.
The scooped
edition. Now, the point that was cut was when Simon Cowell, who's one of the judges, asks Harry... Now, what are you going to play for us?
Yeah.
Now, Harry, in the unedited bit, goes on to say, I'm going to play Train's Hey Soul Sister.
Yes.
The bit that went to air cut out, the best part of a minute and a half.
Yeah.
And it just went to Harry going, I'm going to play...
Isn't She Lovely by Stevie Wonder, the famous audition that everyone knows.
Exactly.
He hasn't really nailed it.
Exactly. So see if you can listen back now and see what the unedited version sounded like.
All right, what are you going to sing?
I'm going to sing Hey Soul Sister by Train.
Well, Lulu's going to be happy. It's his favourite song.
No, I love that song, Harry. That's my favourite song on the charts.
I love that song.
Me too. Train.
Hey Soul Sister, ain't that Mr. Mister on the radio, stereo, the way you move ain't fair, you know. Hey Soul Sister. Tonight.
I don't know whether it's the track that's throwing you, but can I hear something just you without any music?
Okay. I'll do Isn't She Lovely by Stevie Wonder.
Okay, good luck.
Isn't she lovely? Isn't she wonderful? Isn't she precious? Less than 1 minute old. And I never thought through love we'd be making one as lovely as she. But isn't she lovely, made from love?
So that's the full audition. So he comes out with Train, and it is, without being too rude to the big man, I know he listens, it's pretty god. It's pretty fucking god awful.
Yeah, it's the not great. It's not exactly. It's not what I was expecting from a multi-million dollar musician.
Yeah, he sounds like he's like out of key, almost to the point where it's like, did they play a track that he didn't practice
and
to?
The first note. It's so cute how nervous he is. The first thing that he does, 16-year-old Harry Styles. Just launches into the weirdest noise that I've ever heard. Just goes
and like his, if you actually watch the audition, he's strutting his stuff.
I know, yeah. He's
feel bad.
He's very chipper.
Because he's quite the showman still.
And then Simon like legit says, stop. And then Harry goes, what's wrong with that, eh? He says, sing something good and I'll make you a fucking $1 million
man.
It is funny because he's like, obviously like now he's like super popular, like movie star, rock star, you know, pretty.
He goes all right.
That he's just like butchering this song. And you tell he's like looking at girls in the crowd. Like
he gave him a smile.
And it's like, oh, dude, please stop.
He comes out with, hey, soul sister.
What a shitty song.
It's a funny backing track. As well.
Yeah, it's like, yeah, they just got some acoustic. Yeah.
That's worse than some of the bag tracks where you get proud songs.
Well, maybe they're on the same little sites that we are. It was an interesting way they cut it.
Yeah.
And I find the timing of it being released now quite bizarre in itself, that they've released the whole extended edition.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, it makes you wonder, like, why did they cut it out? Initially, because oftentimes when they do make those sort of X Factor type shows, they like having a bit of like there's always the narrative for the people. So even someone coming out and they're like,
cocking
he's
it up.
Fucked up, and then it would like cut to the parents to be like, oh no,
yeah,
oh no, he's butchered it, you know, and then they come back. But what I think is also maybe because they had the whole like X Factor making One Direction was like a really big thing, so it's almost like they're like,
protect
anything that
asset.
Makes these five boys look bad.
We can't.
They're not going to be in the show. Like they are our.
Yeah.
They're our boys, you know.
Because I think the grander public would have viewed him at the time and gone, "Fuck, he's not all that flash."
Yeah.
Having seen the Train element of it.
Oh yeah.
He would have just copped.
Have got voted as well.
Yeah. No, he would have just copped a fair bit of criticism, I would imagine, off the top.
Yeah. Yeah.
But to not even include that is, that's the magic of showbiz.
Yes, you know, you never know what. What is what you're saying? What's true? What's not?
Exactly.
The hardest part for mine, and it comes down to that bloke named Lou. What's his
name? Yeah, Lou Walsh. So he's like a music manager for a lot of Irish boy bands.
We've got Simon Cowell, and then we got the bird in the middle.
Yeah, Nicole.
Scherzinger?
Yeah.
One of one. And then we've got Lou Richards.
Yeah, Lulu, which Simon calls him in a way which makes it feel like Simon don't like him very much. He's like, oh, Lulu, you love Soul Sister, don't you? And he's like,
little bitch.
Oh, it's my favourite song on the Pops.
Now, Lou, credit to Lou. He didn't change his opinion. Like, he stuck to his guns.
Yeah.
Which we're about to hear. But Lou, unfortunately, would have had to explain this next bit basically from the point that Harry auditioned
many a year ago
to yesterday.
Okay, Louis.
Harry, for all the right reasons, I am going to say no because I don't think you're ready.
I actually don't think they booed you loud enough there.
Simon's just put the foot in as well.
Yeah, even that shows that like Simon's like marking down on his freaking thing. This is how we're going to produce the show. We're going to make it look like Harry's a beast. And Lulu's freaking Lulu. Why is Lulu on the panel? I'm a genius.
And so poor Lou, he's gone on. How many years ago did Harry audition?
I think that was 2014.
So 10 years, 8 years now.
Oh, no, it would have been even earlier. Sorry.
Yeah, yeah, much earlier.
I was in like year 7 when they were big. So it would have been like 2011, maybe.
From that moment, Lou has basically, every party he's gone to, every conversation he's been a part of, he's always been the guy that said no to Harry Styles.
Yep.
And up until yesterday, there's no real reason because everyone's just seen the Stevie Wonder stuff.
I remember watching his audition after like he was big.
Yeah.
And I was like, oh, like, yeah, like that was actually so impressive. I didn't realize he was this good at singing when he was so young.
Yeah.
And then that Lou guy is just like,
no. Nope.
Actually, you know what? That didn't really do it for me. Yeah.
But no one has had the context that.
To why?
Of, the whole train episode that took place.
I understand.
I feel like Lou, like, whenever people come up to him, like his kids and stuff, like they're like, Lou, like, what are you doing? Like, what were you thinking, you know? Yeah.
And he's just forever going to have to go like, oh, no, he played Soul Sister, which is one of my favorite songs on the Pops. And he absolutely butchered it. And no one in the world is going to believe that Harry Styles butchered a song.
It's like his daughter buys the new Fine Line album or Harry's House. And she's playing it on a record player at home. And you know how, like, our dad, and like many dads, they'll tell a story 700 times to their children.
Yeah.
I bet he's told that story to his daughter. No, actually, it's fucking dog shit. It's fucking dog shit.
You should have seen the first time he auditioned. I would love to see if he has come out in the public eye and gone. Because surely he's been asked about that.
Well, that's the thing. Yeah,
he's like a producer and manager of Boyzone and
the fact that he did
Girlzone.
Like, leak that ever? Yeah. Like, unless he must have been under like an NDA.
Didn't Harry, like, that's a funny like late night talk show thing to say, like,
it's never come
out. Oh, they cut out. I don't know. Why would you not make a joke about that? Like, you could tell that's a story for Kimmel.
What do you reckon all the other boys are saying to Harry? Harry, right?
They're giving a bit of this.
Hey, yo, what the fuck?
Can you imagine if you also auditioned to X Factor that year and you butchered Train? And you're like, hey, Simon.
Simon.
Hey, what the fuck?
Where was my second go? So there's a few learnings to take from this. One, don't be afraid to give someone a second go.
Yep.
Two, Lou, you're just an idiot. Because even if you did hear the Stevie Wonder thing and you still said no, mate, jog on, Ledge. Jog on. All right, boys, it's time for our favorite weekly segment. It is our only weekly segment. It's time for the whoop. Everyday Hero. And for the first time, it's episode 97, and for the first time ever, Mr. Joe, the man to my left, coming in at a humble 5'3", is bringing us the first ever Joe back-to-back Everyday Hero.
Yes, a double header. Hey guys, what's going on? It's my weekly segment where I talk about some cool guy that I've seen. Last time it was a computer repair man.
All girl.
But 2 weeks ago.
How much cash did you get for that as well, by the way?
He knocked $10 off the price.
Did he actually?
I don't know. He said 49 and it was only 40, so.
The only bloke in the whole of WA that doesn't need a discount on computer goods. Man to my left.
Literally.
Yeah, anyway, so I'm back again with another Everyday Hero. And this came from the classic Frio game that I was at Friday night. Yeah,
oh, my God. Full circle.
Yeah, so
we come full circle.
So occasionally when you go to sporting events, and this doesn't make it to the broadcast, so only if you're lucky enough to be able to go to them in person, there's little competitions and stuff they do to get the crowd hyped up.
Yeah.
And one of these is a dance competition, right?
Joe's talking about this like he attends them frequently.
Yeah.
This may be the first game you've been at this year.
No, I went to the Collingwood game.
Second game you've been to this year?
No, I think we went to another one.
just broad sweeping statement that I'm not going to contest.
What was I just saying? Oh, yeah. And then, so they do like, it's like a dance cam that goes up on the big jumbotron.
Yeah.
And everyone's dancing around. Oftentimes it's kids and kids get a real kick out of it.
Yeah.
And then oftentimes it'll go to an adult who does not want to dance, but they're on the camera and they need to partake. And occasionally there'll be someone who's absolutely blew out of their mind, who's absolutely loving the dancing. So we were up in the nosebleeds in like the 500 section, which I actually like sitting up there. You feel like,
You like mix it with the scum for a bit.
That's
good. Joe calls it charity when he goes to the footy and sits anywhere else.
Well, I'm
the poor people. Hello, poor people. We're all one today.
I'll have a single fin. Isn't that what you commoners drink?
It's always good to see how the other half live, isn't it, Joe?
Yeah, especially because I usually have a pretty good view because I've got my little opera-noculars. but anyway, we were up in this section and then there was like a cameraman in our section filming.
Yeah.
Because obviously, you know, the more people want to be on screen.
They're also pretty rowdy. It's always up the back that they start filming.
Yeah, they don't spend as much money on the ticket. They spend equally as much
on the drinks. Yeah. Anyway, so there was a guy there and they were like filming a lot of people. And I personally didn't want to be filmed because, you know, I was, you know, in the ball seat.
It's not good for his brand.
Yeah. And, you know, people are like, oh, it's the podcast guy. What the hell? Look at him. He thought he was to be well off or whatever. But anyway, people were like loving it. I was like, you know, face down, did not want to be in this video.
Hiding under Cody.
And they were panning around. And then they were like, oh, the prize was like $100.
A seat upgrade.
Yeah, the prize was like a $100 Macca's voucher.
Oh, petty cash.
Sure, I wouldn't even blink for that amount of money.
I'll give you $100 to not put me on the camera.
I was paying people $100 to form a dance wall. there was one guy and he was like up, across the rail, like front row of the top section. Okay. And then his mate was like to the camera, he's like, oh, come, you gotta come film this guy.
Yeah.
So he did and they filmed him and he was up on the big screen and it was like at the end of the, you know, dance round. So he ended up winning the dance-a-thon.
Oh, shit, good on him.
And he was actually like riffing it. He was like busting some crazy moves and I was like, oh, who's the guy? You know, he's having a good time.
Yeah, it doesn't matter how much he earns. He's just having a good time.
Yeah. We're all people. all of us.
So, yeah, anyway, so he does it. He wins the prize. So he's like, oh, that's cool. He gets the $100 gift card.
Don't start laughing. $100 is still good money, Joe.
Yeah, no, it is.
Some of us takes a few hours to get it. Not a few seconds.
Anyway, this guy, and then so the cameraman's there, and then this woman just hands him like a bag.
Oh, shit.
And it's like the prize.
His belongings.
No, it's like the prize. So he got a $100 gift card, but he also got a bunch, because Macca's was like the sponsor for this dance thing.
Oh, holy shit.
He also got a bunch of, there's like a bunch of like McDonald's like merch and stuff. So there was like Keep Cup, socks, like t-shirts and just like a bunch of stuff.
Oh, they need a clover for
it's like a homeless care package. That's what it's sounding like.
But he was there. And then there was also like a bunch of the other kids who were dancing as well.
Okay.
So he gets his prize and stuff. And then he's like looking at all the stuff and he's like, this is like the Keep Cup. Who wants the Keep Cup? And then so he starts giving it out to the kids.
So he's that poor.
So this is where you've sort of seen.
Wait a minute.
I'm actually, there's two people that shouldn't be up here. It's me and it's you, my man.
Fellow brethren.
Fellow
rich man.
This guy was out there.
How's your tax back?
He was shaking his booty. He was winning the prize.
Winning the booty.
But he wasn't winning it for him. He was winning it for
the poor. The poor people.
He was almost like a dance Robin Hood, you know?
Yeah.
Stealing from the rich McDonald's and giving to the poor, the people in the safe.
Hell yeah.
But yeah, he just seemed like such a good guy. And he was getting, you know, like he was like throwing, you know, the socks and stuff to the kids, and the kids were like, "Oh yes, I want the mug, whatever." And then he was throwing it out, and pithing, it was just like
pithing chromatic mugs at people. Of the
and you know, like, everyone in the, everyone in the block was sort of like, "What's this guy?" Like, oh, like shit, like that guy's like so nice. Like all these kids in the block are so happy and stuff. And it's like, you know, it's very easy if you win a prize to be like, "Oh yeah, I won this.
Yeah,
I am the king of dancing."
Yeah, like,
so but yeah, he was just so like, it was almost like, I think the thing that made it so like heroic was like the kids weren't asking for it. He was looking at
it out.
And it was almost like a first instinct was like,
"Let's share.
These socks are going to give these kids more joy." And it's like, cool, they won this thing at the Macca's comp. Yeah. Yeah, you know, I just thought it was a really nice moment.
There you go. Well, that's lovely. And you took some life learnings away? Like, it's not always about yourself, how much you can just bring in for yourself.
Yeah, so I took some life learnings. Also, on my way down, I noticed he had the gift card next to him, so I grabbed that. And I'm easy on him. $100 is still $100. But yeah, it was a great heartfelt moment. Friday night footy, get around it. The season's still got some good games. You could go and you could dance and you can spread joy to lots of other people as well.
We absolutely love that, Joey. And we got the video. So the video will be on YouTube. So if you are keen to watch,
you're videoing.
Yeah, well,
yeah, when he was giving it away, because I was like, cool. Oh, I can talk about this on my podcast, I can monetize this.
It's tax money making opportunity.
It's good. No, it's good. Joe does it in his annual report. Like, you got to always report on how much money you made and then, like, the stuff that you did for the good of the people.
Yeah. Yep.
Charity work and
that's
stuff.
That's a deductible, so yeah.
He does have to document, like, when he does sit up in the scum seats, the big man. So that's why this week's Everyday Hero goes to the dance cam, Happy Man, give him all the prize sort of yes. thing. Sort of
that guy.
Give him out the prizes.
Good on him.
We love that. Alrighty, boys, that brings us to the end of another episode of the MacPack Podcast. Just want to say massive thanks to everybody who's been listening.
Thanks for sticking around.
It was a bit of a good... This was a good ep.
Yeah, we're back in Australia after last week.
Last week was shit.
Dry July really took a tail. Look at good words.
Yeah, took a tail. None of us did
it. It took a turn. No, none of us did it.
But the vibes in general were down.
It's annoying when you go out and people are like, no, I'm not going to have one.
Well, yeah, fuck off, cunt.
Yeah. Have a beer.
Have a beer. Only
yeah,
leave,
man.
Only and then ones. When you do go out, it's only the degenerates who can't give up drinking for a month.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's us. So, thanks for sticking around.
Yeah.
You little cheeky devils have stuck to the end. You get to hear a little bit of cheeky stuff.
You do.
Next few apps.
So, good app. Just going to quickly review the app. We often review
also,
the app.
Also, just on that. Like, obviously, this being a podcast and stuff, we don't get a lot of feedback on individual apps. But, you know, feel free to, you know, rip into us. Or
yeah, let us
tell
know.
Tell us if you like an episode.
Yeah. Or if just like any of the episodes, that'd be good to know as well.
Now, sometimes you are just talking into the void.
We don't know what the fuck you're thinking.
Yeah. No, we have been... I've noticed we've gotten a lot of DMs in the last couple of weeks. So if you're thinking about sending us a DM... Fucking ping on through because we can never get enough.
Yeah, just about anything.
Even if you don't fucking listen, just ping in like your shopping list or whatever you want to let us know about.
You need someone to talk to.
Yeah, fucking we'll do
it's
it.
Three of us.
We got plenty of time. We got plenty of time to reply to you.
Fuck yeah.
Yeah, that's basically all we wanted to say.
Yeah, we've got some big announcements.
Are you going to get picked up?
Off mic? No, probably not.
I just dropped a big fart.
Symbolic of the...
Yeah, the episode was good up to this point.
Boys, it's Eps 97. Yeah. We're only three away from Ep 100.
Yes.
If you are listening and you've got an idea as to something fun we can do for Ep 100, ping them in because, you know...
We thought the impression game was really the best we could get up.
And Harry Styles.
Glad we went early on it.
Harry Styles.
We do actually have some very exciting news regarding a couple of guests who we are going to have on. Are we going to do it? Yeah, fuck it.
Don't say.
Ep 99. We're going to have them on episode 99.
Yes.
God, I hope it works out.
As long as the timing, heavy asterisks, as long as the timing works out and we can get the quasi draft schedule confirmed.
Yep.
If it won't be Ep 99, I imagine it'll be Ep 100.
Which is even cooler.
Yeah, would we do them on Ep 100?
Might have to.
Anyway, beggars can't be choosers.
I mean, if we could. Anyway,
101 doesn't. 99. We're hopeful that we got a couple of big guests joining us on the pod.
Yeah, and you'll know who these guys are.
Yeah, you'll know these guys. You'll know these mothers.
We've just cut it down to multiples,
and we've just
and Australia and
Hamish and Andy are joining us on Ep. Not quite.
One day.
So that's 99. 100, we're still looking for ideas.
Yep.
Ping them in. We're very busy. We probably only think about it...
The day of.
Yeah, as we're sitting down. Other exciting news?
Not yet.
Andy's studio.
We've got a lot in the works. The studio. You should see the boys. They come over to mine. Not you two, obviously. The builders who are building this new studio. Oh, they are working overtime. I get in there some days, you know.
Yeah. It's going to...
Not early, but I get in the room that we're going to do the studio in. I'm like, boys, what's the timeline on this one? And they just go, oh...
Fucked.
It's mate, it's such a big job to build this.
Yeah, rivaling Abbey Road at the moment.
Yeah, it's shaping up to be quite a thought process. You know how long it took to build Optus Stadium? That's sort of the time period they've given me for the studio, which I think is fair enough because by the time we're done, we want to be able to fit a full 60 nearly people in there, I reckon.
At least a table and some chairs.
Yeah, at least six people in there. But yeah.
Until then.
That's happening though. Just keep that on the DL. That's happening.
Yeah, baby.
There's a lot of construction taking place in my place. I'll go over there now. It's about 10:30 on a Monday night, but
the boys will still be there.
Yeah, they're working overtime. They are busting their ass. If we get this thing before Christmas, I'll be over the moon. Some of the timelines I've been told about just moving this table into a room. Fuck, man. it's fucking it's exciting. But when it does come, and it will come, it'll be incredibly exciting.
A lot of logistics.
We'll call it there.
Yeah, we'll call it there.
Boys, been an absolute pleasure.
Always is.
Until we do this time. Next. Remember to stay safe, stay blessed, and always remember to...
Go give your mama.
It's chuffing out, but not forever.